Grifter's Hymnal from Ray Wylie Hubbard is chock full of tasty grooves and witty lyrics. One well-crafted tune on that album is the autobiographical song, Mother Blues. Here's the song story from the man himself.
Pretty close, it really is. That there was one name was changed. It wasn't because he was innocent, it was because he was guilty, yeah, so when I cut the song, it was just, you know, I'm very fortunate to know Tony Joe White and kind of put in the reference to Folk Salad Annie, and he was very gracious to allow me to put that on there. So it works well, you know.
I was a young man about 21 years old, y'all. All I wanted was a stripper girlfriend and a gold top Les Paul. Be careful of the things you wish for. You might get them. There was a nightclub in Dallas. It's called Mother Blues. It's where Lightning Hopkins played and Freddie King even paid some dues. And all the dealers and gamblers and young white hipsters, they all made the scene. The girl at the door who checked IDs was just 16. It was not a place for law-abiding citizens. Jackie Jones, he had him a habit. He just couldn't stop. Said, give me $500 and they say I'm a Les Paul gold top. I drove my daddy's car down to Ross Avenue and I sold it. I guess I should have told him, alluded to the police that someone stole it. It was just the first of many bad decisions I had to make for the next 20 years. Oh, but I had me a guitar. Everybody knows that the real nightlife begins after the club's closed. What they call after hours. It's 2 a.m. and everybody's gone but the band, the dealers, and Jack Jones. And then the girls from the Landing Strip Club come over after they put their clothes back on. So I'm at my blues, I'm sitting on an amp, I'm playing Twist and Shout, and this tall. A drink of water, walk in, look like she might have to shoot her way out. She come up to me, she says, you know anything good on that guitar? I didn't say nothing, I just kept on playing. She said, you ever heard this song called Poke Salad Annie? I just kept on playing. She said, every time I hear that song, my insides feel like warm butter. And I just want to take off my clothes and dance around in my underwear. I said, down in the Louisiana, where the alligator grows mean. Whoa, that's all I knew of it. But it was enough. It was enough. So we hit it off. Me and this dancer hit it off like a metaphor. Like a metaphor for a hydrogen bomb. We was enriched uranium, supercritical mass. We was a chain reaction. It was a love and lust. Mostly lust, but a mutual attraction. So there I was, boys, at 21 years old. Oh, I had it all. I had a fine stripper girlfriend and a gold top Les Paul. The future, it looked promising. But there were dark clouds on the horizon. She was a beautiful girl, but she liked to drink tequila, and oh, that ain't all. And I come home 4-5 times, she pulled my Les Paul. So we broke up, and she went to Hollywood. She married an actor, She got a job dancing on the Hudson Brothers TV show, and Molly Lester for Max Factor. Ah, I got over. I'm glad she done all right. I'm glad she done all right. Yes, I am. But now me, I never busted through the gates into the big times to rock a roll star. For 40 years I just been carrying around an old gold top guitar. But love and fate are mysterious things in this funky old world. Yeah, it's 20 years ago I ended up marrying that Mother Blues door girl. Ah, we had us a boy and he's 18 years old now and he's playing guitar. And he ended up with that Les Paul gold top. And what does he do? He plays an SG. But I'm very grateful for the time that I get to share the stage with my son Lucas. I'm very grateful for the time I get to share the stage with George Reeve on bass and Rick Richards on drums. And I'm grateful I get to write these old songs and travel around and play them. And the days that I keep my gratitude higher than my expectations, I have really good days.
Stay with us, folks. We'll have Midnight River Choir with a full performance coming up next.